Roll call, please.
Mr. Assett.
Here.
Mr. Bain.
Here.
Mr. Bashir.
Here.
Mrs. Broadwater.
Here.
Mr. Delarose.
Here.
Mr. Dorsey. Mr. Harvey.
Here.
Mrs. Kaminsky.
Here.
Mrs. Terabecchia.
Here.
Would you stand for the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under law, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Item two, superintendent's remarks.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just have a few announcements. On May 14th, some of our students attended the Pennsylvania Junior Academy of Science State Composite Competition at Penn State University Park. We've had several first and second place winners. These are competitions that are carried on throughout the state and centered at Penn State. I'd like to let the community know of our students that received awards. Angela Becker, this is at the high school, first place chemistry. Dominique Ballone, second place chemistry. Brad Bridovich, second place biology. Scott Gardner, second place zoology. Jennifer Kutek, second place biochem. Christian Sessick, second place chemistry. At the middle school level, Alexandra Donkers, second place biology, and Jeffrey Crummer, first place physics. Congratulations to them. Also like to congratulate Francesca Legros. Francesca's been nominated to serve on the Pennsylvania Community Service Advisory Board. This is in part because of the activities of the students that were awarded the Jefferson Award in Community Service. So congratulations to her. That's a huge nomination. And also an accomplishment for one of our graduates here from Brownsville High School. I'd like to congratulate Amber Lynn DeDominick. During the spring commencements at Penn State University, she was not nominated, but she was considered for the Student Marshal. Student Marshal Award goes to the most accomplished graduate overall in a college of talented and bright students with a graduating class of over 300 students. Amber earned a BS degree with highest distinction in energy engineering in the energy engineering program. She also earned a minor in environmental engineering. So congratulations to one of our graduates from Brownsville Area High School. And also a final thank you to the Republic Girl Scouts for a community service award. They helped in clearing the football field and around the bleachers of all of the incidentals over the last year. It looks fantastic. It's nice and clean and ready for the season. So thank you very much to them.
Superintendent, I want to add to that. This was Browning Troop number 51034. The girls were Cora Gira, Lyric Schuff, Kendall Dillinger, and Carmela Kolar. Parent volunteers were Laura Gira, the leader, Heather Schuff, leader, Ken Dillinger, Karen Dillinger, Wendy Kolar, and Francis Van Divener. Those people raked clean under the bleachers at the football field, which you know is pretty bad. And plus they cleaned up the brush, the sticks, and I think there's approximately 50 bags of garbage, and it took them 2 days. So. It was a project, the Girl Scouts will be the project, and we certainly gave them one. Okay, item three, public remarks on agenda items. Anyone who wishes to speak, please come forward, state your name and nature of business. Here's the microphone.
Good evening, folks. My name is Matt Edgel. I'm the representative from the Pennsylvania State Education Association.
speaking to, I guess the agenda item would be on budget, and I represent the Brownsville teachers. Now, I'm not going to take up much of your time. You have a little bit more on your plate tonight than usual, so I'm going to try to defer to that. I just want you to know that I'm, as the new rep from the Pennsylvania State Education Association, we're going to do everything we can to help settle a contract and get it so that the board can have a settled budget by the time the new school year rolls around. I know we were supposed to have negotiations next week. You know, those got canceled. I understand that. Those kind of things happen. But I want you to know we're going to do everything in our power to work with the board to make sure that we get a good contract. So, all right, thank you very much.
Thank you. Please come forward, state your name on agenda items. You will have another chance at the end of the meeting. I believe we'll be going to a brief executive session, which will leave you people here when we come back. Is there anyone else wishing to speak on agenda items now? Okay, seeing no one. Item four, adoption of agenda and related materials for cooperation in the minutes. Motion by Director Delarose.
Second.
Second by Director Harvey. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item five, approval of the April 19, 2012 board minutes. Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Terbecchia. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Item five, Mr. Dorsey's absent, so we will go with the approval of the April 2012 General Fund Cafeteria, Title 1, 2, 3, Treasurer Financial Reports. Motion by Director Terbecchia, second by Director Delarose. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Acid?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
No.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Terbecchia?
Yes.
Item seven, approval of the following funds you have before you. Motion by Director Harvey, second by Director Delarose. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Terbecchia?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
No.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Acid?
Yes.
Item eight, solicitor's report, Mr. Davis.
Mr. Chairman, I, with my understanding, we had some issues we need to discuss in executive session involving legal and employees, personnel rather. And if we could, I'd ask for an executive session.
This time would be appropriate. Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Bain for an executive session. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? This is for personnel legal matters. You people can stay. We're going to go in the back. We're out at 7:08. We'll hopefully be very brief. Second by Director Acid. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Back in at 7:50. We were in there for one legal item. Also want to make an announcement. Monday night we had an executive session for 1 hour and 10 minutes for legal purposes. Okay.
May I continue with my report?
Yes, Mr. Davis.
Mr. Chairman, we have with us today Attorney Anthony Sanchez, special counsel, Mr. Sanchez. We have with us today Attorney Anthony Sanchez, who is serving the district as special counsel. Mr. Sanchez practices exclusively in constitutional and employment law, and he's going to read a statement, which is the policy of the, I'm going to say it's the position, if you will, of the district.
Thank you. As you know, the lawsuit had been filed and there was a consent order entered into at the court between the district and the ACLU. Part of the consent order was that a certain statement be read, and your solicitor can go to this. I believe it's consistent with the policies you already have. The statement is that all students have the constitutional right to remain seated during the Pledge of Allegiance, and no student will be punished for exercising that right. Should a student elect to remain seated, they must sit quietly while those who choose to recite the pledge do so. This was part of the court order that this would be read at this meeting.
Thank you, and thanks for that explanation, Mr. Sanchez. Mr. Chairman, I have nothing further to report, and I just wanted to get that out of the way.
Can we get comments on that?
No.
Not on that issue. There'll be other issues I'm sure you may want to comment on.
Okay, Education Director Harvey.
I move to approve the attached list of 2012 Brownsville Area High School graduates, providing all students meet academic and financial obligations. Commencement will be on May 30th, 2012 at 6 p.m. in the Brownsville Area High School gymnasium.
I have a motion by Director Harvey, second by Director Broadwater. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Personnel, Director Delarose.
I move to set the rate of pay for non-professional substitute employees at $8.25 per hour, effective May 18th, 2012.
A motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Bain. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Assett?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Beshear?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Terabecki?
Yes.
Item B, I move to add Marianne Salka to the professional substitute list.
Second. A motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Terabecki. Questions? All in favor?
Yes, sir.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Item C, I move for all professional and non-professional substitutes to be paid bi-weekly.
I second.
A motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Bain. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Item D, I move to accept the attached resignation letter of retirement of the following staff members, contingent upon the language of the current collective bargaining agreement, effective at the end of 2011-12 school year. Martha Davis, middle school librarian. Deborah Gonzalez, elementary guidance counselor.
Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions?
Question. I just want to thank Mrs. Davis and Mrs. Gonzalez. They've done a very good job, and we hate to see them go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Item E, I move to approve an extension of an unpaid child rearing leave of absence from Ms. Dana Rose, elementary school nurse, for the 2012-2013 school year.
Second.
Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Terbecki. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
F, I move to approve the attached list of professional and non-professional substitutes, letters of assurance to be submitted to Interstate Tax Service for the 2012-2013 school year in compliance with the Department of Labor and Industry regulations.
Second. Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions? I'll take roll call on that, please.
Mrs. Terabecchia?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Beshear?
Yes.
Mr. Bain? Mr. Assett?
Yes. Yes.
Item G, I move to approve the operation of the food summer service program to operate out of the Brownsville Area Middle School from approximately June 11, 2012 to August 17, 2012. Meals are free to all children aged 18 and under. Adults may purchase meals at a reduced cost. The district will not incur any costs as a result of this program.
Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Bain. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Item H, I move to elect Jeff Bain as treasurer, elected effective July 1st, 2012 through June 30th, 2013.
I second
motion. Motion by Director Delarose, second by Director Broadwater. Questions? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Mr. Davis?
recommendation of Special Counsel Anthony Sanchez and the further recommendation of the Brownsville Area School District's Insurance Carrier School Claims Service, I move to settle the case of NB, a minor, by and through her mother, Carolyn Raja, on behalf of her daughter, versus Brownsville Area School District, Philip J. Savini Jr., District Superintendent Vincent Nesser, Principal Brownsville Area Middle School, and Jessica Van Meter, Teacher, Brownsville Area Middle School District, case number 2012 CV 566, in the Federal District Court for the Western District of Pennsylvania, for the sum of $5,000 paid as council fees by the Brownsville Area School District, and the sum of $11,000 paid by the School Claims Service, for a total payment of $16,000, and to authorize. Solicitor, school superintendent, school board president, and the school board secretary to execute any and all documents necessary to finalize settlement with payment to be made in exchange for all executed release and discontinuance of the action. It is so moved. May 17th, 2012.
Have a motion. Second by Director Delarose. I have a motion and a second at this time. This is a new item, so I will take public comment from the audience. You may come forward, please state your name, and I'm going to give you 3 minutes because I assume that you'll be able to. You will take the microphone and try to keep it under 3 inches, somewhere around there. Please state your name, Marcy.
My name is Marcy Saga. I'm a taxpayer, I'm an employee. I am appalled at anybody that would not want to say the Pledge of Allegiance. These men in this audience that served in our wars gives you the right to do what you do. Everybody ought to be ashamed of themselves. And if it was my kid, I'd have went up that school and he would have recited it in front of everybody. You would not
forefathers, and when you open this door for this lawsuit to go through, we're in big trouble.
Yes.
And I want to thank you for listening to what I have to say.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lewis Hostler. Some of you in the room know me. I'm a Vietnam veteran of the Vietnam War, served in 1965, 66, 67, 68, 69 in South Vietnam. I am a taxpayer of this school district. I have helped elect many members of this school board. I totally disagree with the motion that they have made tonight. I would like to bring up a few things, and I know that they're going to cut me short. But there's a few things I'd like to say that people might not know. In 1892, a gentleman wrote the Pledge of Allegiance. Very few changes from 1892 up until 1954, until President Eisenhower added the words "under God." Now, when this lady refused to say the Pledge of Allegiance, I believe that she should have went to the office and said, "I have a problem with the Pledge of Allegiance. There's something in there that I don't agree with, maybe a religious thing or the problem with under God." But this nation was founded under God. When our ancestors, everyone in this room, I know, came from a foreign country. I know that because we were all immigrants at one time. The only people that were here were the Indians. Whenever we came here, we settled the colonies, and the first thing we were told by the King of England was to build churches and to build towns and make settlements and mostly live under the word of God. Whenever the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor, the last four words that were said by the President of the United States, "So help us God." The very next day, the Nazis declared war on the United States and joined with Japan. We got into a bitter war that lasted 6 years. We lost 416,000 men that believed in that flag and believed in this nation. They all worshiped that flag. And that flag is a living piece of material. It's not a piece of cloth, it's a living item. And it's a, for all the men that gave their lives for this nation, some of which I put in the lobby up there, some of them that are graduates from Brownsville High School that are on some of them photos in the lobby. You know, we went to Korea. We lost 53,000 men in the name of peace and freedom for this country and for the people of South Korea. Then we were invited into Vietnam. We were invited into Vietnam to stop the flow of communism. My unit was one of the first to hit the beaches, was the big red one.
I'm sorry. We're trying to get 3 minutes. I'm not trying to cut you off.
You got three minutes.
Can't do that. Solicitor says I can't do that, so if you could conclude.
That's
too bad.
Gotta follow the law here.
Yeah, that's right. Follow the rules.
I believe the rules are that someone that else wants to speak on the same subject can give up their 3 minutes of time.
I'll sit here for 5 hours. It doesn't bother me. I don't want anybody to speak.
That's right.
That gentleman's next. As soon as you're done, he can take that microphone.
That's right. Stay here all night.
Donnie, do you want to give up your 3 minutes? Or do you want to say, there's a gentleman back there to give up his 3 minutes. Do you have to honor that?
Then please continue.
When we all entered the service, we were given this small piece of paper.
You got them all, brothers.
It's called the Code of Conduct. It has 6 basic rules. It's given to every officer, every enlisted man, every member of the armed forces. It's called the Code of Conduct. And I believe there is a code of conduct for this school district.
Exactly.
And it's a code that these teachers live by to teach what they're learning in college and how to teach students. But this code of conduct has some very big rules under it. And number one, it says, "I am an American fighting man. I serve in the armed forces which guard this country and its way of life. I am prepared to give my life in its defense. Number two, I will never surrender of my own free will. If I am in command, I will never surrender my men, and they will have the means, as long as they have the means to resist. Number three, if I am captured, I will continue to resist by all means whenever able. I will make every effort to escape, and I will neither accept any pardon or any special favors from my enemy. But it goes down under six articles, but there's one very important article, and it's number six. I will never forget that I am an American fighting man, responsible for my actions, and dedicated to the principles which made my country free. I will trust in my God and in the United States of America. I support all people's rights. Card-carrying member for many years. And I'd be more than glad to join the ACLU. But I believe the ACLU has bigger battles like we had in Vietnam. We didn't fool with the little battles like it is here in Brownsville School District. The ACLU has bigger battles to fight for much bigger problems than we have here in Brownsville. You know, but I'd like to read this. I don't know who the author is, but it's, consider the words. And it goes like this. It is the soldier, not the reporter, who has given us freedom of the press. It is the soldier, not the poet, who has given us freedom of speech. It is the soldier, not the campus organizer, who has given us the freedom to demonstrate. It is the soldier, not the lawyer, who has given us the right to a free trial. It is the soldier who salutes the flag, serves under the flag, and whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protester to burn the flag. No truer words were ever spoken. I don't know who wrote it, but the guy had a great heart. But, you know, this school district is in a heap of trouble, financial-wise. All the money that's been taken back from the governor's office, and, you know, funds are tight, and the taxpayers of this school district are kind of fed up with the school tax, and I know all these legal matters, it's just the tip of the iceberg. If they make this decision tonight to pay, it's just the tip of the iceberg in Pennsylvania. It'll spread through every school district in Pennsylvania. These school directors don't know exactly what they're asking for. They're going to base law on this decision. And there are a few decisions right now that have been made throughout the country. I'd like to show you this. Came out today in a yearbook published by this middle school. In a yearbook published by this middle school. Has a nice picture, patriotic pride. Today, it is our privilege to say thank you to American veterans to let them know that we appreciate them for their service. Today, we at Brownsville Area Middle School celebrate American veterans for keeping this nation the land of the free and the home of the brave. Published it in the yearbook, it just came out today. So, what are we looking at? Every veteran that's in this room tonight, they know what it is to fight for your country and fight under that flag. And to lose a friend. In the times that I spent in Vietnam in the infantry for over 3 years, I lost a lot of good friends.
Amen.
And we fought under that flag, and we fought for each other. And if my child would come home, and they're both in this auditorium right now, in the back there, you know, my daughter, my son, my wife, if they would ever come home and told me they refused to recite the Pledge of Allegiance, my kids couldn't sit down for the next month. You know, if this young lady that we're talking about, I know she's a great student. I think if she had a problem with the Pledge of Allegiance, she could just very, one day she said the Pledge of Allegiance, the next day she said no, she refused to say it. Well, if she had a problem with any part of that, go to the office with a letter and tell them, you know, I got a problem. You know, and I believe that's a code of conduct. That's a code of conduct that each and every student in this building should live by. And I think it's the duty of the teachers to teach, do what they were trained for and to try to teach. You know, today the parents at home, they have two jobs. They're trying to run a household. They're both working. Maybe they don't have as much time as we had to supervise our children and teach our children the right ways of this country. There are four items to become a citizen of the United States. If you come from Mexico or if you come from Italy today and you want to become a naturalized citizen, there are four main things that you must do to become a citizen. One is to give up all allegiance to the country that you come from. The second item is that you pledge allegiance to the United States of America. Once again, you know, I'm a concerned taxpayer. You know, I didn't go to this school, but I graduated from Brownsville High School in 1962. And I was an honor student. Out of the first 10 in the class, I was number 10, and there was 9 girls in front of me. I wasn't a straight A student, but I didn't get many B's, I'll tell you that. But that's enough about me. But I appreciate all the veterans that came out tonight, and I know there's other veterans that have things to say. And I know I've been very long on words, but I guarantee you, if this school board votes to pay tonight, I'll work my ass off to see that they never get elected in this school district again.
Hello, I'm Earl Mansberry. I spend
1969-1970 at Phuket Air Base, South Canaan, and on Dogman. Also, I want to say we knew the gentleman here was a Purple Heart recipient. We have many Purple Heart recipients with us. Now, these guys, just like myself, put our life on the line every day that we was in Vietnam. And we're not looking for glory or anything, but what we are looking for is what we call respect. You don't have to respect me personally, but you ought to respect to give you the right to not say the Pledge of Allegiance, but you ought to respect to stand up and honor the men that fought. I'll call her a little girl, and her parents ought to take a trip down to a VA hospital and to Arlington Cemetery and to see these service people, men and women, with no legs, no arms, and because they were blown up, and plus the fact there's a board out there with all the GIs in Fayette County that got killed in Fayette County. We owe those people, those GIs, respect. Whether you believe in or not, you at least ought to stand up and respect somebody that gives you the right to eat and breathe freely in this country. Don't you think for one minute, those GIs that come back from Afghanistan, Vietnam, War II, just would like to have the opportunity to stand up for 2 minutes on their own feet to recite the Pledge of Allegiance. That privilege was taken away from them, and they did not have to go to a court of law or anything, or an ACLU. It was taken away from them. You know, it makes me mad, it disgusts me, what's going on? And you have one kid doing this. Where in the world's the parents? Don't the parents respect this daggone country? You know, you teach respect to the teachers, you teach respect to the government. You may not, my politics with President Obama, they differ. But I respect the man, and I respect his office. And that's where it should be.
Thank you. Thank you.
My name's Don Coleman. I'm not used to talking on a microphone.
Sorry.
I'm not no speaker. That you people know that we're thankful that we can talk here tonight and express our opinion. And I hope I don't see no boredom in your faces because this is not no game we're playing. This is serious business, and that's why we're here. Just like Earl said, we're not here for no glory. We're not here for no recognition. We're used to not getting it. We got it when we come home 40-some years ago. Okay? We're used to all the negative and all the bad stuff, and we're here to try to get this straightened out. And I hope you all appreciate it.
Thank you.
As far as this family goes, could I ask where the girl is that won't stand up for the pledge?
She's not here.
She's not here. Where's the parents at?
I'm her mother.
And your stepfather. I would ask Jones. I should say you all, to be proper, to drop his suit. If you have any kind of respect for your country and what you can do in this country, I don't know what all you get out of this country, but if you have any respect, you will drop this lawsuit. This is your school district. taxpayers here in Brownsville School District. You want your child to grow up and be respectful. Do you, Mom? Would it be the right way to, what's that, ma'am?
I said, you really shouldn't be doing this.
I shouldn't be doing this? Ma'am, I fought for this country. I have as much right, unless you want to come up here and get this microphone, you can ask me. What I'm getting at, we're trying to teach these children respect. This school board and the school teachers are doing their best to teach these kids respect. And if you don't like it, the lady there that's complaining because I'm up here talking, you ought to move over to Afghanistan. You can sit there and laugh all you want, but this is serious business. We have people die for this flag. There's 50 boys out there on that wall from Vietnam. Of course, you probably don't remember that.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And like I said, this is serious business, okay? My question is, where does the ACLU come in to deal with the school district and come here and tell our school district how to run? Run it. Are they here tonight?
First of all, I'm limited in what I can say, but I can say this. That the attorneys for the American Civil Liberties Union are representing the plaintiffs in the lawsuit.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all I can really
say. Okay, but I say we hear about the ACLU.
That is an organization which has attorneys that are employed by that organization. Mm-hmm.
Well, why do we even let them in this? Are they going to manage this school district? Tell us how to teach our children?
Of course, there are lawyers that represent persons, and that's their legal duty, and that's what they do.
I know, okay.
And that's all. That's all I can say about it.
Okay, so the family got the ACLU to represent them.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, I'm dumb about this. That's why I'm asking.
Well, I don't know. I think you're pretty smart, but I can't comment on any of that. I can okay. just say that that's what happened.
Okay, maybe we ought to, the majority, does we still have a democracy in this country? We have a majority rules. I mean, when we have elections, majority rules. Maybe the taxpayers in this township ought to have something to say about whether they pay this bill or not. I mean, what does the school board think? Did anybody think that the taxpayers ought to have something to say about it?
I think I have something to say about it.
I got to get no answer. Okay.
Why don't we have the family donate that money to the veterans?
The taxpayers. Can I have your attention, please, for Jimmy? The taxpayers keep the school district in money. Am I correct or am I not correct about that?
And I'm one of them. Yeah, and they do.
That's right.
That, and you understand that. But you also understand, and whatever decision that the district, these people make, these representatives of the taxpayers, rest assured that it's a decision that's difficult, and rest assured that it's made because of economics. It's
okay.
an economic issue.
Okay.
And that's what they're faced with. And it's a very difficult thing to be faced with that.
Yeah.
And you know, I personally, and I think I can speak for every board member, support what the veterans have done, support those of our men and women in Afghanistan and Iraq that are protecting us, support them in every way that they can. Each of them. There's everybody up here has okay. family that served. I have had family serve. Mm-hmm. That yearbook that was read, my wife wrote that. My mm-hmm. wife did that. She did the yearbook this year for middle school. So what I guess my point is, it boils down to economics, and these are difficult economic decisions. It also boils down to the fact that each school director here takes an oath, and the oath is to follow the Constitution. Not necessarily agree with it, not necessarily like it, mm-hmm. but to follow it. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately,
They've been placed in a very difficult position.
Well, I will say, and like I said, I'm not here to harass anybody.
No one thinks you are. No one suggests what you're doing.
Yeah, and I'm not here to harass this family. What I'm here for is try to teach this family about respect for our country, okay? And if you support our troops in Iraq and Afghanistan now, you will not pay this bill, okay? There was a young man that found this over his computer over in Afghanistan. He wrote an article in our paper, our Uniontown paper, and his buddy lost both of his legs. And he wrote an article, you know, his buddy might not make it. They're not sure of that. And he just wonders if his buddy had his both legs, that he would stand up and be glad to say the Pledge of Allegiance.
You know what?
Okay.
I stand up for him and say it.
And so, you know, do you, as a mom, do you think this is right to do this with your child?
Yeah.
Pretty much.
I mean, we're just talking here, you know. And we have a lot of veterans here that don't like this. Like I said, this is serious business. When we don't show respect to the country and our flag, we take this to heart, and I think you ought to be able to see that now. You understand what I'm saying?
I do.
Okay. And like I ask you, if you do anything, make this right with your school district. This is your school district too. You know, your child goes to this school district, so it's your school district. And make it right with them, unless it's just about money. Okay. I don't know if it is, but, you know, he said we have economic problems. We all have economic problems. But this is not no way to get money. If I would have been able to sue my school district over the paddles I got when I was in school, I'd be a millionaire.
Thank you!
Us veterans, when we signed to be in the military, I was drafted, and I spent August 67 to August 68 in Vietnam. I was in for 2 years. When I come home, I got out. But when we signed on the dotted line, we signed for our life. You know, we didn't just sign to serve in the military or go into Vietnam. We signed to give our life for our country. And that's why this means so much to us, ma'am. I hope this sinks into you a little bit. This,
I understand it totally.
Yeah, that's good, because you know, this is what this is all about, is the veterans and this country and what we stand for. And it's nothing, no more, no less. So, but what I'm saying, we signed, a lot of young men before my time gave their life for this country. And they didn't get to come back home. They was 19, 20, 22, they didn't get to come back home. And then, so we gotta keep this going, you know. They would love to be here right now and do this. And we gotta keep this going, and we're not gonna back off. We're not gonna give up. And if it's not just about money, then let's get this straightened out and drop it and get on with your life. I don't think your daughter should have to stand up. Say the pledge if she don't want to. From what I understand, that's her right. But I think she should have to stand up or squat, stand in the hall. You know, and what's going to be the next thing that our children in our school districts are going to do? You know, do they want to refuse to do their math for this semester, or do their phys ed, and then I guess the ACLU will come in and say they don't have to do that. You know, I'm being serious. Well, but I'm saying it might get to the point someday we might not be able to fly our flag at our home even. I mean, that might sound stupid, but they're taking our rights away. They're taking our privileges away. When our forefathers wrote this Constitution, they didn't write it to take God out of it. They didn't write it to show disrespect to our country and our flag. It was meant to show the respect, and it was meant to keep that going. They didn't expect this to happen, but we can't even stand up for a minute and say the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. So, I'm going to shut up here in a minute. I think as far as the ACLU, I don't know how many of them veterans served their country, but I think they're undermining our school district, what we're trying to teach our children. If they was coming in here, we had a problem with somebody getting discriminated against because there's Italians or Polish or whatever, that's a different story, you know. They're trying to undermine what you all are trying to teach our children, okay? And I don't think you should let that happen, you know. I mean, somebody's got to stand up and stand their ground sometime. And I think you just need to stand your ground this time.
That's right. And
we have a lot of people, a lot of veterans out here that think the same way, and we're not all wrong, okay? And like I said, I'm happy these people stay here and listen to us. That makes me feel good about these people, okay? And I hope they, like I ask them, to drop this and let your child go on with her life and let her learn some respect. And I'm sure you want her, if you're a mother, you want your child to learn respect. And I don't think anybody would say any different. And that's all this is about. It's not about, bowing down to something that's unreal or, it's important. And we have a lot of veterans here that says it should be done the right way. And I think that's all I basically have to say.
Thank you. Okay. Before any other speakers come forward, I've been advised to please direct your comments to the board or take aim at me. Okay, or whatever you want to say, I can take it. So please direct your comments to me or the board. Would be much appreciated. I don't care what you say. I'm having a microphone technical difficulty here.
My name is Rob Doria. I'm representing the American Legion. I'm the 24th District Commander, Fayette, Somerset County is in this district. I would just like for all the veterans, if you could please stand up in the back of the audience here. I would like to thank you guys for showing up. You took some time out of your life to come here. And I think it's our fault as veterans. We're not in the schools. We're not telling our youngsters what the flag meant to us, what it meant to others. We have programs and we're falling short on them. It's our fault this kind of stuff happens. There is a motion that the board has. I would like to see him amend that motion. I mean, we're only talking about money here, right?
Right.
Let's go ahead and pay the family. And let's pay everybody else who said the Pledge of Allegiance twice as much. some of us will remember, going way back, TV shows. I'm sure some of the board members remember Red Skelton had a TV show. You know, he had a very small skit on the Pledge of Allegiance. When he was a little boy, the principal came in his room. Kids were reciting the Pledge of Allegiance. And he says, "Fellas, I think you're just going through the motions here. Let me explain this to you." And he took every word of the Pledge of Allegiance and explained it to the kids. And if you ever have a chance to listen to that or see it, you will have a greater appreciation of what all those words mean. You know, we live in a democracy. We all fought to defend democracy. This is all part of it. So, you know, it's nice to have the showing that we have here. We got to get more involved in our schools as veterans, every veterans group. You know, just two more things. I was once in a foreign country. I was an aviator. We had a forced landing. We had to land in a foreign country. I had to walk across the tarmac, file a flight plan by myself. I got into this building, and there was probably as many people in this building as there is here now. And I got rushed. I thought I was going to get mobbed to death. But the whole issue was, these people approached me. They seen a flag on my arm. They wanted to touch the American flag. That was their whole underlying motive. I thought I was going to get mobbed to death, but once I realized they just wanted to touch the flag that was on my sleeve, that's something I hold dear to me. It's very important to me, and I carry it with me every day. Every time I see the flag, it comes to my mind. There is a book that was written, 1776. I don't know if anybody's read that book or not, but the Continental Army didn't have a lot of money. When the British were chasing them around up in Massachusetts, New York, Connecticut, it was in winter, it was snow, it was cold. Continental Army didn't have any boots. Well, I should say the boots and shoes they had wore out. So it was easy for the British to chase them around because they just had to follow the blood trail in the snow. That's the kind of sacrifice that created this country, and I think we got away from it. Again, I would just like for the board to amend their motion. Pay all the kids who did stand up, say the pledge, twice as much as what you're paying a member not to say. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Josh Reed. I'm an Iraq war veteran. Served in the United States Army from 2003 till 2010. When I was a senior in high school, September 11th, 2001, we were attacked. And that's what it took for this country to come together, to be united for one country and one cause. And it takes something like this for a community to come together for what's right. And what I'm trying to say here is a lawsuit for somebody who doesn't have enough self-respect to stand up for somebody who fought for your right to say what you're saying. So you have that right to believe in whoever you want to believe in. When I was in Iraq, I had thousands of Muslims around me who thanked me and said they had prayed for me by their God for liberating their country. And then I come home to my country and show this utter disrespect.
That's right.
It disgusts me. As far as I'm concerned, I ain't never met a 14-year-old person who knew the phone number at ACLU.
Yeah.
Hey, I went to state prison. We deal with these idiots all the time because someone always has something going on. They'll sue over anything.
That's right.
It's terrible. You know, I got this thing right here. if anyone in this room hasn't ever read it. It's the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution of the United States of America. In the back of this book, where it has the signatures of all of our forefathers who signed it, there's not one Muslim, there's not one Buddhist, there's not one Wiccan that signed that book. And if anyone doesn't believe me, they come take a look at it. And it just, it amazed me that an attorney who believes in God, or supposedly believes in God, could twist our forefathers' words into some gibberish so somebody can have some free money. Free money! Get a job, pay your taxes, and if you don't like it, I'll personally buy you a plane ticket back to wherever the hell you came from.
Thank you. Okay, again, let me, before you go, sir, please address this board. Address me or the superintendent or solicitor. Please look at, address us if you can. Thank you. Go ahead, sir.
My name is Chief Mass Sergeant Richard Pachasco, 171st Every Fully Wing, retired 2009. And I want to just the board here on a couple of different issues. See these things on my arm? I'm Chief Master Sergeant. It was 100% of the people in the Air Force get promoted to this rank. I went through a lot of schooling. I went through a lot of different things to get this rank. Okay? I'm here to tell you that when this military goes to another country, the first thing we're trained to do is understand the culture of that country. Honor and respect the culture of that country. I've been fortunate myself. A lot of people think I'm not fortunate because I've been able to serve this country in a couple of different conflicts in my life. I was in Vietnam, Desert Storm, Southern, Northern, Watch in Iraq. I've been Saudi Arabia, tried to go to Afghanistan, couldn't go because I was getting out of the military, but they sent me. I just want to make a couple of statements here about the culture that we have to honor and respect these other countries we go to. There's not much for when the people come to this country to honor and respect ours. Whether you believe in it or not, at least honor and respect our culture and our people. Now there's a couple of words said here today by a lot of gentlemen here. A lot of good words were spoken here tonight. A lot of them. But when it comes down to it, it's not only the veterans who are being disgraced here. It's every citizen of the United States of America. Every citizen. Every citizen. You might have not fought for it, but it's every citizen that's being disrespected here. So I would appreciate the people that are found in this suit to take into consideration. Just like the gentleman spoke, I heard what Red Skelton had to say. Go on YouTube, punch up Red Skelton about the Pledge of Allegiance, and listen to his very words. It's touching. And I believe if these people would do that and listen to that, I think they would be moved. Honor. Respect yourself as a citizen of the United States of America. And that's all I have to say. God bless America.
Thank you.
My name is Lori Hostler. My father spoke here today, and I just want to say that he is right. He would have kicked my ass. All right. But I am a 1994 graduate of this school. My senior year, there was an incident with teachers.
Did the audience hear her?
Okay, I graduated from this school in 1994. There was a lockout, and it was over teachers, and every kid who walked out of this school got out of school suspension. I was one of them. My parents told me, it's fine that you believe in what you're walking out for. Yes, they didn't punish me for it. However, this child did get in school suspension, am I right? right? In school suspension?
We cannot comment.
Okay. I do believe that it is this child's given right to not stand and not speak it. I mean, excuse me, not say it. But to stand, I don't see a problem with it. That's my opinion. When I was in school, there was several kids that were, you know, did not believe in God, were atheists, whatever. During the Pledge of Allegiance, they either left the room or just stood there and didn't say it. Nothing was ever said to these kids. They were never criticized for it. I just don't understand why, you know, the board has to come up with this decision to pay money for something for in-school suspension. Granted, I do believe that, you know, it is this child's given right. That's what this country was founded on. But I walked out of this school and got out of school suspension. My parents did not sue this school. The 50 other kids, 60 other kids that walked out with me did not sue this school. That's all I want to say.
Thank you.
I'm Lester Ward, and I'm from Brownsville. Like the gentleman before me, the veterans, I only had 26 years in the military, so I was there for a while. Again, my thing is, we talked about one student who did not conform. What about the hundreds of other students that do conform every day? And I see a multitude of good students coming out of this high school, and they are being taught to respect themselves, the flag, our country. When I left Vietnam, by the way, I'm of the age that also was on the tag end of Korea. So you veterans know from where I come. I was in Vietnam, boots on the ground twice, with like the my brother Hustler over there, 9th Division, all the way. I would only say I respect the family for whatever they're standing behind their kid. I respect the family for that. But I would hope that the school board would consider, at the most, if you want to do something for the student, I would say, we're sorry that you were given a suspension, if that is necessary, but to pay for disobedience in itself, I don't think that's right. I think that we as a community and as a citizen, we owe a whole deal of thanks to the school board itself. Realize that money is scarce, and we should conserve that mock commodity. Please reconsider that situation. If there's any way that we can work with the ACLU, because they are a legal entity. You can't go over them, you can't go around them, you have to work with them. I understand that. But please reconsider on how we can come to peace with this family, and how we can respect not only the students, other students of the school, but also our taxpaying system. And I'm one of them. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Anyone else? Try to limit your 3 minutes if possible.
Hi, my name is Marlene Brad, and I'm going to give Marcy my 3 minutes.
One quick question. How much would it cost if we did not pay, if we fought it? Estimate.
Huh? It'll be astronomical.
Just can people hear me?
I'm usually loud enough without a mic.
I know that feeling.
Yeah. Well, let me get a mic. I want to make sure everyone's okay.
Hello, my name is Tony Sanchez, and I'm the attorney that's been appointed to represent the district in this matter. I come from a background of civil rights, as the solicitor said, and employment discrimination cases and things of this ilk. I can tell you that under the law, if someone is successful in bringing a civil rights lawsuit, They are entitled not only to whatever damage that they receive, whatever a jury would determine or a court, but they are also entitled to have their attorney's fees paid by the entity they're suing, i.e. the school district. So in cases where individuals sue successfully in civil rights, it could be astronomical the amount of money that can result in attorney's fees. It doesn't matter how much is won. If it's just some sort of way of prevailing, they are entitled to their attorney's fees, and it's, in my tenure of doing this, I've seen fee petitions as high as $600,000.
So your advice would be just to pay it and move on, correct? Whether it's right or not, that's what you believe in. Whether it's right or wrong, okay, just pay it and move on, correct? Because that would be the best thing to do, and just let it go. Because if we don't pay it, we're looking at legal fees, probably hundreds and thousands of dollars, correct? I mean, I don't agree with it. I don't think we should pay it. I just wanted to know what it would cost to move forward in this district and let it go and learn from the experience, because I sue flag every opportunity I get, because I respect everybody, okay? But if it's going to cost hundreds and thousands of dollars, just like the veteran said, pay it, move forward, and let's throw everybody else a party that does stand up and support our veterans.
I would like Mr. Sanchez to share with the public what he shared with the board on Monday night, stating where a school district it was $600,000. However, the ACLU got that, right? What did the actual child get?
There was a case, thank you. I have to be very careful as to what I comment to as I am representing the district. So, but I can't tell you about other matters, and there was another matter where the ACLU, it's public record, with Hermitage School District up north, a small district, and that was a case that involved a student creating a MySpace profile. The school district disciplined the student. The student sued under the student represented by the ACLU, brought suit, claiming the First Amendment was violated. That case was taken all the way to the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court decided not to hear it. That case involves probably a $500 million of attorney's fees.
My question.
Oh, there's a child. The child received $7,500.
How much?
They're petitioning for that amount.
Okay, they're petitioning for that amount. That hasn't been decided.
Just so they know that's not on the record.
Yeah, that's right.
Thank you, Greg, for all the votes. Anyone else before the vote is taken?
Good evening. Most of you know me.
We don't know. You got to tell us your name.
My name is Billy Bain. I'm a principal. President Mr. Shear, yes. Members of the board, Attorney Davis. As your stage says here, at a moment like this, I am not against the ACLU. It fights for many good things. My question is this. Was the student disciplined for not saying the words or not standing?
Ms. Bain, you can't call me.
My next statement is, can a child then sue with the ACLU for being told to remain in their seats?
I really can't answer that, because that's a question that would be better directed to the attorneys for the ACLU. So honestly, I really could not answer that question.
Okay. Well,
I am, not the attorney that's handling the plaintiff's case.
I'm not a veteran.
Excuse me. Audience, the lady has the floor, please. Thank you.
I'm not a veteran. I am the child of a veteran. I am the wife of a veteran. I am the mother of a veteran. And I have lost many, many, many friends that are veterans. I lived at El Toro. I want to tell you, I thank God for this flag and for the teachers that taught my children what their rights were. And I thank God for the veterans that fought to defend my right. And I, as a parent, recommend that every parent instill patriotism in their child. I recommend that. I will fight for your right, and I have done it many times. But I will die for this country and your right to disagree. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to proceed. If
I don't, this gentleman does.
Go ahead.
Tom Nagy gave me 3 minutes.
If Tom Nagy give you 3 minutes, yep. You deserve 3 minutes.
Again, let me just say,
my name is Donnie Coleman, sir.
I was just going to announce that at the advice that try to limit to 3 minutes because okay. I'm being told that we could be have problems.
It seems like we ask questions and nobody can give us no answer.
I'll answer
and I know all you people up here is a lot smarter than me, okay?
I'll answer anything.
What I don't understand here, the lady just asked that this child was disciplined for disturbing the class, for not saying the pledge. I mean, why was she disciplined to start all this?
We cannot comment.
You can't comment on that.
I would love to tell you, but I can't.
You know, this is, it's you know, I'm not a real smart person, but this is stupid. For us to stand here and ask a question and nobody can tell us what's going on.
But it's the federal,
this child.
It's the federal law, Sergeant.
Yeah, federal law. This child was disciplined for something, but we don't seem to can find out what it is now.
Sir, let me say this. Excuse me. We know what it is as a board. We cannot divulge anything while it's in litigation at this time to anyone. There's going to be a vote taken here shortly.
Yeah. So in other words, if a child, we'll just forget about the pledge and stuff. If a child refuses to, what was that? It's been a long time since I've been in school. To go to gym class or something.
Do his homework, something like
or
that.
Or do their homework or something. If they're disciplined, then this UCLA that everybody thinks, they think so much of, that all they're after is money, then they can sue the school district. I mean, you're opening up a can of worms there. You know, somebody's got to stand their ground, and I don't understand why nobody can tell me why this child was disciplined. I thought it was over not standing up and saying the Pledge of Allegiance and disturbing the class. Now, that's what I was told. That's all hearsay. I can't, you know, but we got a bunch of people up here that's in charge of the school board and can't tell us nothing. You know, I mean, that don't make no sense to me.
Just to answer briefly, sir, the best way I can.
What'd you say?
We can't tell anything to try to protect what's left of the district's situation at this point. We're trying to protect the district's, I don't know what the word is at this point, but we cannot divulge anything at this point. Sooner or later, it will all come out. But at this time tonight, at 9 o'clock, until this vote's taken, we
better have anything.
I'll first please escort them out.
You better have lots of money because I think these kids are gonna They want to get some money to their families.
You may be right, sir.
Like I said, it don't make no sense to me. You know.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you for nothing. I mean, I'm not being smart, but
no, I understand.
I don't understand why somebody on this school board can't tell me why this child was disciplined. That don't make a bit of sense to me. Now, you know, I try to be a gentleman about this, but that, you're talking to me like I'm stupid.
No, sir. No, sir. I will meet with you personally after the meeting if you wish. I have no problem telling you.
Crap.
Luke, go ahead. Please, 3 minutes and no more.
I'm only going to take about 1 second or two here. I know you guys got something to do. You guys are all elected officials. But every one of you guys went to school every day. You stood up and you said the Pledge of Allegiance. Under one man under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I don't know why anybody else, why you got to sit down during this. Okay, I went to school, you guys went to school, we all said it. You all said it. All right? So that's all I have to say. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. That's Luke.
It's me.
Last person, please. Hi, Earl Mansberry, Vietnam 69-7. I'm going to give you a little history lesson about the Vietnam veteran. When a Vietnam veteran went to war in Vietnam, he come home. He didn't come home to parades. He didn't come home to cheery crowds. He come home to a country that spat upon him, that protested against him, that hated him. We could not even say that I'm a Vietnam veteran. We had to do it in secret. Because you know why? Because the American public at that time, back in the 60s and part of the 70s, protested against us for some ungodly reason. And we only did what we were told to do to go and fight for our country over in South Vietnam to free these people and to come home to a disrespectful country. That is the reason why we're here today. Because we were disrespected. Oh, today, there's people reaches their hands out and said, thank you. They see this Vietnam veteran. They reach out to us. Thank you for serving. Where the hell were you 40 years ago when I come home and I was 20 years old? And that's the reason why this is all about respect. Mr. Mansberry, you have to address us, please.
Big pardon?
Please address us.
Okay, Paul, that is the reason why.
Howard me.
Okay. I'm Paul Judd.
It's okay.
That is the reason why that we are here today. Because it all deals in respect. Not to say the Pledge of Allegiance, but by God, stand up and respect the people that give you the right to get up every goddamn morning and eat, sleep, breathe, and go to school and to learn something. You know, and I've been fight by Afghanistan soldiers, Iraqi soldiers, because you know what? We led the way. We were persecuted by our own country back then. Times has changed. We appreciate our military now. And I am very, just like me and my comrades there, we are very happy to see our military appreciated. So basically, what I'm saying is all deals in respect. Thank you, sir.
Last one, please.
My name's Daniel Vogel. I encourage this family to drop this thing. I encourage it because we need this school open. We need what little money we have teaching our kids values. Not teaching them to get in some kind of a wizard contest because of politics. I encourage the school board to take a stand on this. This is what America's about. We never took the easy way, we took the hard way because it was right. This is right. Whether you want to see it or not, it's right. People lived and died for this flag. There is something called school policy. I don't know, maybe that can't be inflicted on us, I don't know. But this is the right thing to do. And if you're willing to sacrifice this, what are you gonna be willing to sacrifice next week, the week after? So I encourage you, both sides, to drop this, keep the money in our school district, teaching our kids values, and stand up for what's right, not for what's easy.
Thank you, sir. Okay, I have a motion and a second. I have a motion and a second. You have the motion, Linda?
Yes.
I have a motion and a second on that. Go ahead, roll call, please.
Mr. Acid?
No.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Yes, this was. But you can make your comment.
Okay, I like to make a comment. This afternoon, I was...
Can't hear you, Mrs. Broadwater.
None of them are working.
Hello?
Okay, go ahead.
This afternoon, I received a phone call, and I really come to this meeting tonight very hopeful. I was so excited about it, and I am close friends with several members of the board. I just began to pray about it. And I said, Lord, let this be true when I'm here. And it was a message that said, from this person on a phone, that the parent of the child was reconsidering and she was going to dismiss the lawsuit. I had a lot of hope, and I just knew it in my heart when we went back into the library room here, that that's what was going to be told us, however, it wasn't. But I just want to say that pledging the flag is a privilege. And they said back there that this is the end, this will be the end. If it's voted yes, it's the end. Is this the end or is this the beginning? That's all I have to say, thank you.
Okay. Linda, you have one vote for Director Acid. Go ahead, continue.
Mrs. Broadwater?
No.
Your vote.
No.
Mr. Harvey?
No.
Mr. Bain?
No.
Mr. Delarose?
No.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Absolutely no.
Yes!
Absolutely no. The American flag in the United States of America. Okay. I've been told to make would make no comments. I'm sorry. I apologize for my why don't. Do you have a total, please?
You have a total of one absent, 8 no's.
8-0. Okay. Hey, stick around, please. People, finance director, baby.
The offer of Maccabee Industrial to settle all claims as set forth in the suit filed at number 2797 of 2010 GD Fayette County, Pennsylvania for the sum of $40,000 and further authorize the solicitor, superintendent, board president, board secretary to sign all documents necessary to settle and resolve the lawsuit with the payment being made in exchange for fully executed release and filing of a precipice to settle and discontinue with the authoritary of Fayette County, Pennsylvania.
Thank you.
A motion by Director Bain.
Second.
Second by Director Terabecchia. Questions?
Question. this is another lawsuit against our school district by a company that we hired to do work that did not finish the work and walked out. And it's just more money that they want to take away from our district and our children. And my vote on this one would be an absolute no also.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Go ahead, Mr. Director.
I voted being no too, and I voted for these people because they were local and I thought they would really be right by the school district, and they considered their work done. And they walked out this work and really left Brownsville in a mess.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Go ahead, Mr. Bain.
Question on
my comment on this is, I wasn't on the board at the time of any of this, and I can't put any vote for either way on something that I'm not involved in.
Okay, I have a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Terabecchia.
No.
Mrs. Kaminsky.
No.
Mr. Harvey.
No.
Mr. Delrose. Mrs. Broadwater.
No.
Mr. Bashir.
No.
Mr. Bain.
No.
Mr. Acid.
No.
Oh yeah, you skipped one, Director Bain.
Can I make a comment, Rocky? If you look at the last two votes we made, the whole board was unanimous, so I think we made a statement here tonight. Very well.
Thank you. Director Bain.
I'd like to make a motion to designate June 21st, 2012 at 7 p.m. at the Brownsville Area High School Auditorium, 1 Falcon Drive, Pennsylvania, Brownsville, Pennsylvania, as the date, time, and place for the final adoption of the 2012-2013 general fund budget.
A motion by Director Bain.
Second.
Second by Director Terabecchia. Questions? All in favor? Aye. Opposed? Athletic Director Acid.
First, Mr. Brashear, I'd like to congratulate all our spring sports on successful seasons, especially our baseball team. First round game, they were eliminated last night. Okay, item A, consider a motion to hire Keith Harvey as equipment manager for the 2012-2013 school year with a stipend of $7,200.
Motion by Director Acid, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions? Roll call, please.
Yes.
Mr. Bain.
Pass.
Mr. Bashir.
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater.
Yes.
Mr. Delrose.
Yes.
Mr. Harvey.
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky.
Yes.
Mrs. Terabecchia.
Yes.
Mr. Bain, you wish to leave that as a pass?
Yes.
Item B, consider a motion to hire Scott Roebuck as athletic director for the 2012-2013 school year with a stipend of $6,300.
Motion by Director Acid, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Terabecchia?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Delrose?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Acid?
Yes. Item C, consider a motion to hire Scott Roebuck as faculty manager 2012-2013 school year with a stipend of $1,500.
Motion by Director Acid, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions?
Question. I don't know what a faculty manager does, but I also feel it should be part of the athletic director's job, so I'm going to vote no on this.
Okay, a motion and a second. Roll call, please.
Mr. Acid?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Delrose?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
No.
Mrs. Terabecchia?
Item D, consider a motion to hire Rachel Roschak as head varsity cheerleader coach for the 2012-2013 school year term with compensation set at $1,000.
Motion by Director Acid, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Acid?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Brashear?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Dorsey?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Delrose?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Terabecchia?
Yes.
Item E, consider a motion to hire Carrie Cabina, assistant varsity cheerleading coach for the 2012-2013 school term. Compensation set at $1,000.
Motion by Director Acid, second by Director Terabecchia. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Acid?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Delrose?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Terrabecchia?
Yes.
Okay, I'd like to also congratulate the baseball team on a successful season. Coach Raymond. All right, before I get to the motions, I'd just like to make a comment that the following motions demonstrate the difficult decisions that are before this board as we face the financial difficulties attributed to several causes, but bottom of that list are the budget cuts imposed upon by our governor. But these, like I said, are first in line of many decisions that we need to make as a board to recognize fiscal responsibility and diligence in this district. With that, I move to close Cardell Elementary School at the conclusion of the 2011-2012 school year in accordance with the provisions of Section 780 of the Public School Code. The closing of Cardell Elementary School will improve the Brownsville Area School District's overall operation, making it more effective, efficient, and economical. The Board President, Board Secretary, Superintendent, and Solicitor are hereby authorized and directed to prepare and submit an application to the Pennsylvania Department of Education consistent with the outcome of this motion.
Second.
I have a motion by Director Harvey, second by Director Terrabecchia. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mr. Assett?
Yes.
Mr. Main?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Terrabecchia?
Yes.
I move to authorize the superintendent to solicit sealed bids for the sale of the Cardell Elementary School building and property and to publish and advertise the solicitation for sealed bids in the Herald-Standard and Fayette Legal Journal and by handbills posted at or near the school facility and throughout the community, subject to the invitation for sealed bids, which is attached and incorporated in this motion. Bids shall be due by the 17th day of June 2012 at 1 p.m. at the Brownsville Area School District Administration Office, located at 5 Falcon Drive, Brownsville, Pennsylvania, 15417, and recommendation for action upon said bids received will be presented to the board at the regular board meeting to be held on the 21st day of June 2012 at 7 p.m. at the Brownsville Area High School Auditorium, again, 5 Falcon Drive, Brownsville, PA, 15417. The board reserves the right to accept or reject any and all bids.
A motion by Director Harvey, second by Director Terrabecchia. Questions? Roll call, please.
Mrs. Terrabecchia?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mr. Bay?
Yes.
And Mr. Assett?
Yes.
I move to seek bids to repair the tennis courts at the high school facility.
Motion by Director Harvey, second by Director Bain. Questions?
Question. I'm going to vote no until we have a budget, until we see what we have to cut, whether it's going to be educational programs, because I will not cut those. So I'm voting no on this to do any kind of repairs until we have our budget meeting.
This is a motion to select bids. Just let me remind board members that this is just a motion to seek bids. I appreciate your input, but I just want to make that clarification. I also, if you noticed at the end of my motion, I said at the high school facility, I think that was supposed to be part of the motion, because technically there are tennis courts at the middle school, and that is not included in this motion.
Gotcha. I have a motion and a second. All in favor? Go ahead, before that.
This is just to seek a bid, right?
Yes.
Yes. This isn't actually the work.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mrs. Terrabecchia?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
No.
Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mr. Delarose?
Yes.
Mrs. Broadwater?
No.
Mr. Bashir?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Assett?
Yes.
Okay, addendum to the education policy. Consider a motion to consolidate grades with all Brownsville area students. Brownsville area students in K-1 and 2 to attend Cox Donahue Elementary, and Brownsville area students
grades 3, 4, and 5 in Central Elementary School with the consolidation begin for the year 2012-13 school year.
Second.
I need a motion. I'm not making it.
I'll make a motion.
Motion by Director Kaminsky, second by Director Caravaggio. Questions?
Before you proceed, Mr. President, if the board were to adopt this motion, it would still require the superintendent to contact the Department of Education for the department's approval.
Okay. I have a motion and a second.
Yes.
A roll call, please.
Mr. Assett?
Yes.
Mr. Bain?
Yes.
Mr. Bashir?
No.
Mr. Delros?
Yes.
Mrs. Brawbar?
No.
Mr. Dorsey's not here. Mr. Harvey?
Yes.
Mrs. Kaminsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Terabecchia?
Yes.
Okay. Item nine, public comments on anything. Please come forward, state your name, make your business. We have a microphone available. Again, I'll state it to 3 minutes, somewhere near there. 1 minute?
Hi, I'm Angela Ryan. I'm a Cardell teacher for now. On Friday, May 4th, Cardell Elementary students and staff took part in a walk to cure juvenile diabetes on the walking track at the Paul Comments of Film Republic. This walk was dedicated in the memory of Kathy Smith, sister of Susan Zupich, who died from juvenile diabetes. Our school raised $2,000 to donate to JDRF. There are many people we would like to thank. Without their support, our success would not have been possible. They are the Redstone Township supervisors for allowing us to use the park at no cost, Frank Rico for donating the use of his buses for transportation to the park, Sherry Kotke for overseeing the transportation of lunches to the park, Susie Zupich and Chad Gaster for planning the day's activities, Mr. Berger, the teachers and students for their participation, Joe Sawyers and John Maseko for donating their time for cleanup of the park, Dr. Savini and Mrs. Kaminsky for attending the walk and cheering on our students, and all the sponsors who donated monetary gifts to make this day a success.
Thank you. Very good. Anyone else take a shot? I mean, you can come up.
Hey, I just want to tell you guys.
There's a limit. Come on.
I just want to tell you guys thank you. And you did the right thing, okay?
Thank you. Anyone else, please? Last chance to let's move. Go ahead, sir. Please state your name, sir.
Hi, my name is David Eric Nuttall. I'm the proud father of Daniel Nuttall, who performed last night in the junior high school band concert. In my hand, I have two DVDs and the program of last night's concert to share with the school board. I am also a volunteer member of FCTV Fayette County Television. This concert will be airing Saturday night at 6 p.m. and also Sunday at 1 o'clock. Again, that's Channel 77 on Atlantic Broadband. And for those of you, these kids did an excellent job last night performing in this concert band. Not only that, and one thing wasn't mentioned, I wish the veterans were here, our kids also march in the Americanism Day Parade in Uniontown on May 1st and did an excellent job. So I want to tell you that there is a viable music program in this district, and those DVDs right there prove that.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Mr. Director Harvey?
I'd like to just follow up on that. I mentioned to her.
Check your mic, Bill.
Just to follow up on that, I just want to reinforce what the gentleman said there. They did. They put on a beautiful, I was here last night, they put on a beautiful performance. We should be proud of the students and the music program that I think is alive and well, again, here in Brownsville. And I thank the students for a great performance in the school for support, and the parents and the teachers. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? You have a motion to adjourn. Director Caravaggio, second by Director Broadwater, all in favor?
Aye.